And the other new feature of OS 5 is the addition of 7 new filter types to the frequency shifter. And in fact, we're now going to call this the filter bank in the release version of the software. All of the new ones fall under these two categories, crossfade and varyslope. I'll show you the varyslope filters first. So we have the typical filter controls that you'd expect of cutoff frequency and resonance. But here we have two brand new parameters that allow a degree of control over the structure of the filter that's never been possible before. Firstly, with the poles, you can fade anywhere between 2 and 6 poles now. And with slope, you can determine exactly how steep each of those poles will be. At its minimum setting, you get 6 decibels per octave that you'd expect with a typical filter. But as you increase it, then the curve becomes, the slope becomes a lot more shallow, and so you end up with a much more gentle effect. So at this extreme, you end up with something which is even more subtle in its effect than a one-pole filter. And I find that really useful for finely sculpting pad sounds, for example. And all of these parameters are available in the mod matrix. I'll show you a sound which makes use of those. So here I'm using LFO 1 to modulate the slope and the poles in opposite directions. This is what that'll sound like. Let's introduce a little bit of modulation from LFO 2 to the resonance parameter. And now to the cutoff as well. This is from LFO 3. Note that this parameter will be called filter bank frequency in the release version. And let's have a quick listen as well to the other two varyslope filters. I'll keep the same modulation settings. Here's the high pass in action. And the band pass. So you can get some very interesting sounds by modulating those parameters. Let's have a look now at the crossfade filters. Now these are available in 4 flavors. We've got 1-pole, 2-pole, 4-pole, and 6-pole. I'll show you the 1-pole first. So the crossfade filters allow you to continuously fade between a low pass and a high pass filter with bandpass on the way. So here we are with a 1-pole low pass. Fully resonant, of course. Let's move it to bandpass. And to high pass. Now the interesting thing about the one pole is that when you have it set to bandpass filter, like so, there is actually no effect on the frequency content of the filter, especially with resonance turned down to 0. You'll find that sweeping the cutoff parameter here will have no effect. However, if you introduce some resonance, you will hear a resonant effect despite that. is a unique effect. And with the other variants of the crossfade filters, you get something a little bit more expected there. So this will be a proper bandpass now. Let's hear a patch where I'm modulating some of those parameters. So that's just modulating the filter type now. You'll see it's assigned to filter bank poles. So that's modulating the actual filter type here. And modulating the frequency. And now some resonance. Let's try that with the other variant. So there you have it, seven fantastic filters. And things to bear in mind with them are that they are monophonic, so they affect all voices simultaneously. And because they're in the effect section, you can't modulate these parameters with the envelopes. However, you can use LFOs, as you've seen. And an added bonus of all this as well is that the resonance parameters of the vowel and comb filters will also respond to modulation now, which makes them even more dynamic.